Just a couple years ago, I found myself getting burnt out from working long hours and trading time for money. A steady income can be valuable in that it provides stability, but it doesn't always allow you to be able to build true wealth. And now I make a living from my passive income alone. So essentially, I'm working smarter and not harder. So in this video, I'm gonna share with you 5 ways to make passive income and to work smarter, not harder. So one way that you can make passive income is develop an online course. This doesn't require you to be a professor. It doesn't even require you to have a degree. While you have to have organization and you have to be able to set up a course that people can actually gain knowledge from and that it offers value, the long-term rewards outweigh the initial work you have to put into it. And what's great is that you can actually do it for free. It does require a great initial investment in terms of your time and energy, but once that course is created, it makes money for itself. And that, my friend, is what we call passive income. Rental property and home purchase. We are always told that it's important to own property and to buy a house, but nobody ever really delves into why. I have a client that I sold a home to just a couple years ago for $300,000. It was a new build, and this borrower stayed in the house a couple years and decided to refinance this year. Once it got appraised, it had increased in value by $25,000. This borrower did not make improvements to the property or add on to it or do anything, just lived in it and gained $25,000 worth of equity.
Now do keep in mind, gaining equity is wonderful, but there are also monthly expenses that come along with the house. Of course, you have your mortgage, you have your property taxes, and then there's closing costs associated with the purchase of a house, as well as if you're going to refi or buy investment property. So keep that in mind when you are considering the benefits as well as the risk of buying a home, an investment property, or doing a refinance.
Investment properties typically require you to put more down. They're a little pricier, but rental properties or investment properties reap passive income. So owning property, whether it's through investment property as a rental property or just your primary residence, just buying a home, can make you money effortlessly, and that is why home ownership is so powerful. Affiliate marketing and social media. So social media has become such a influential and powerful way to generate business and to generate profit and to generate passive income. And it doesn't just start with YouTube. There are so many ways that creators and influencers and people can make money online now, and it's not just designated for large influencers anymore. Now you have opportunities where anyone can generate income from social media and affiliate marketing. You can actually monetize through various websites. There's Magic Links, Rakuten, that you can get cash back on purchases and referrals. There is so many different ways that you can monetize things you use every day, and you don't have to have a large following. Amazon has a really great affiliate marketing program. Your everyday person can now make passive income just from showcasing the things that you use every day. This is an easy, easy way to make some passive income. High yield CDs, savings, and checking accounts are great ways to make passive income. Banks will pay you money just to hold onto your money. Every account that I have reaps some sort of dividends, or I get some sort of money back simply for just having my money sit there and using it. My checking account, I get dividends back. There is a number of online savings accounts. You can get CDs, which are certificates of deposit. You put your money in the bank, you leave it there for a certain amount of time, and they give you money for it.
I do want to note that there are downsides to things like CDs. So for example, CDs tie up your money so that you can't access it without penalties. Also, high yield investments also have high risk that the company will default. Also know, many high yield savings and or checking accounts do have different requirements that vary by the bank and the account type, which can come along with different fees required or certain actions that you have to take in order to qualify for the dividends or the interest that you receive. So just know that there are downsides to this along with the benefits.
Okay, so one major way,
major key
way to make passive income is via the stock market. I have covered the very ground level basics in the first video of my investment series. If you haven't already watched that, you definitely want to check that out. I will link it below and in a card above. Before you go any further in this video, you need to watch that first so that you can get a basic ground level understanding of stocks and the stock market if you're not already really familiar with it. The stock market is a beautiful thing, especially right now. Now, since the onset of coronavirus, the US stock market has been literally a roller coaster, mostly since early March, but it's really gone up from there. With conditions expected to be volatile over the next several years, there has honestly not been a better time in my adult life for me to start learning about the stock market. That's what sparked my interest and got me to really learning about the stock market and just doing tons of research. I read a lot. I stay up on financial knowledge. It has become a really fun hobby for me and a great way to make passive income. And I've even partnered with Robinhood to learn and invest. Now, if you're not already familiar, Robinhood is an investing app. You can download it on your phone and it allows you to invest. What I truly, truly love about Robinhood, and it is truly my favorite investing app, is that it empowers ordinary, everyday people like you and me to do more with their money and to invest. Their goal is to empower people by lowering the barrier to entry. It's really easy to use. There's no commission fees. There's cash management access to ATMs. There's no commission fees or account minimums. So whether you're new to investing and ready to learn, or if you are just in search of a more user-friendly interface, Robinhood is your go-to. Okay, so how do you start investing? Well, when you're looking at a stock that you want to buy, you really want to trust the more long-term trends. Warren Buffett actually advises to consistently buy an S&P 500 low-cost index fund. You really want to trust the long-term trends overall. Don't let your emotions dictate your choices. Don't feel like you need to check your stocks every day. Be patient and know that it takes time. It's a long game. You gotta be patient. Really try to invest in what you believe in. Invest in what you know well, whether that's like an industry or a product. You wanna do your research and make sure you are very knowledgeable about the company, about the industry, about the products, about the services. Don't just buy anything on a whim. Really do your research, really be knowledgeable about it, and really invest in things that you actually believe in. When it comes to buying stocks, knowledge is power, guys. Make sure you know what you're getting into, and if you know what you're doing, your money is more likely to grow. Try to buy in the dips. When a stock is at its peak and highest value that it's been in weeks, you can get really excited and want to just go buy a bunch of shares of it. The same way you would find your favorite shirt or your beauty product on sale, try to buy stock when they are priced lower or in the dip. Prime example, in March, when a lot of stock prices plummeted, that was a really great time to buy stock because it was in the dip, so to speak. So a lot of people who bought stock in the dip found that their money exponentiated once the stock market started recovering and certain stocks started, you know, bouncing back or increasing back to their normal levels above or close to. So, okay, when you're looking at a stock, the first thing you're obviously gonna see is the ticker symbol, and that's usually like four letters that represent that particular company and their stock. You can always go to the search tool in the app, type in a company name, and it'll pull it up. You don't necessarily have to memorize all of the ticker symbols. Just search for the company that you want, and if it's in there, if it's publicly traded, it should come up. So when you are looking at a stock in Robinhood, it will give you a stock table. That stock table will show you some stats of how the particular stock has been performing. It'll tell you how much that stock was when the market opened for that day. So it'll tell you the highest amount that value of that stock reached for that day. It'll tell you the low, so the lowest value that it went to that day. It'll give you the 52-week high, the highest value that that stock has reached in the past 52 weeks. It'll give you the 52-week low, which you can guess is the lowest that that stock went in 52 weeks. Some stock will give you dividends. So those dividends that I talk about where you get money back just for simply putting your money there, there are stocks that will give you dividends. Simply for buying their stock, they'll give you a percentage of how much you invest and they'll give that back to you. So that's a great way to make some passive income, but really just buying stock, especially if you buy it at the dip, you really just want to see that your money is going to grow along with the value of the stock. Like I mentioned in the first video, a stock is simply a piece of ownership in a company. The more money that company earns, the higher value your stock is worth, and the value can grow over time. If you buy a stock and it's at $10 per share, and you buy a share, it's $10, and the company's earnings go higher for that next quarter, the value of that stock may go to $20. So the $10 that you invested now is worth $20. So you see how you're able to just make money literally while you sleep? It's amazing. Starting off, one great way to invest in stocks as a beginner is to invest in ETFs. And what are ETFs? ETFs are exchange traded funds. An ETF is, very simply put, multiple different stocks that are in one fund. So for example, I have a social media ETF and it consists of multiple different social media stock. So if I don't want to throw all my money into one social media stock, I can invest in an ETF and buy shares of an ETF, which is representative of multiple social media stock. And with Robinhood, you can invest in stocks, options, and ETFs right from your phone. It really makes it so easy, and that's one of the reasons why I love Robinhood so much. So when it comes to buying stock and getting started as a beginner, you definitely want to do your research. You want to be very knowledgeable. Take a steady approach. Know that it's going to be steady growth. You don't want to be too aggressive or be short-sighted. You don't want to buy stock off of emotion. You want to take educated risk. You want to be really meticulous about how you buy stock. How can you buy stock? With the Robinhood app is what I suggest. It's my favorite. I think whether you're a beginner or you're advanced, it offers options for everyone. So I really definitely recommend Robinhood for getting started with investing. Now, when you are deciding on what stock to buy, obviously you've already done your research, but you want to look at the stats. And I've gone over what those stats are: the 52-week high, 52-week low. You can look at the average volume that's being traded. You can look at what it opened at, what it closed at, and this can allow you to make an educated risk of if you should buy that stock or not. Now stay tuned, because I'm going to continue this investing series and I'm going to delve even further into investing and how you can make passive income through the stock market. But I want to feed it to you little bits at a time, because I don't want you to get overwhelmed, and I want you to be able to follow along whether you're a beginner or you know a little bit more. I want everyone to be able to learn something from this. So definitely, definitely make sure you check out Robinhood. I will leave the link below, and make sure you stay tuned to my investing series so that you can follow along, learn something, and hopefully gain some passive income from it. Okay. These are just five ways, but there are so many more. So if you guys like this video, please thumbs up and leave your questions below and your requests. Please let me know if you want to see more passive income ideas, and I am happy to create more, whether it's in the investing series or just in general. I really enjoy talking about this stuff. I am obsessed with the stock market lately. I love talking about passive income and generating multiple streams of income. So definitely make sure to let me know. Thumbs up, hit that bell button so you can be notified of my next investment video in this series. Don't forget to subscribe so you can be a part of the fam. And I will see you in my next video.